Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for stopping in today. As you can see, we have a little bit different video. If you were here for my cross stitch videos, I promise those are coming back. But I had a really exciting update in my sewing world, and so I wanted to share with you my new sewing machine. So let me give you a little bit of backstory. So before I got this, and we'll talk about what it is in just a second if you can't already tell, I had a Singer sewing machine. It was just a little, I think, $100 sewing machine from Walmart. It has been wonderful, don't get me wrong. I have made 2 quilts on it, made tons of projects, but it just really was starting to lack as I'm starting to get more advanced in my sewing. I'm by no means an expert. I'm not an advanced level whatsoever, but I'm starting to work on some projects that are a little bit harder, and my machine was just making those hard projects even harder. So I went out looking for a machine, and I knew I wanted a Janome, and so I went to my local Janome dealer and found this beauty. So they let me try out a few different machines. We sat down and we stitched on them, and I ended up going with, I don't know if you can see it here, the Janome 3160PG. And so I decided on this machine, the one they had on the showroom floor. I sat down with it, had a nice tan front. It was pretty, and so, but I really didn't pay much attention to how it looked because I just needed it to function the way I wanted it to. So I sewed with it. I said, okay, that's the one I want. And she came out, and I noticed as we were talking that the box said 100 years. And so this is an anniversary edition of this machine. And I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know if the box was just different. And as we're talking, then she gets to looking and she's like, huh, this is an anniversary machine. It didn't cost any extra, but it's what they had in stock. And so I'm gonna pull it out for you and I'm gonna show you all the surprise I got when we opened this up. So she opened it up with me at the dealership. So it has already been opened. We took it out just to make sure everything was there and everything worked properly before I left the store. The store was phenomenal. They were wonderful. And so I know a lot of you don't know me personally, but my favorite color is pink. If I could show you my kitchen right now, I have a pink KitchenAid mixer. My utensils are pink, pink pot holders, all that. And I just love the color pink. I really, really do. So I thought that this anniversary edition, from the front, it looks red. And so I thought when we pulled this machine out that it was going to be red. And I was shocked because we opened the box and the very first thing, so let me show y'all what it looks like from the top. So you can already start to see there are some pink things in there. So let's look at this. All right. These are bobbins and they might look a little red to you, but so we get the machine out at the store to plug it in and make sure everything is there. And the first thing I see, there we go, is this case of pink bobbins. Okay. Look how cute those are. If you can see that color. So this was my first sign that this machine was 100% meant for me. I knew we made the right decision. Because not only did it come with all of these extra bobbins, but they're pink, which was super cute. So let me pull the machine out for you. All right, one more thing. Right here, it also came with some quilting attachments, and we'll go over that in a second. So this box has like a walking foot, a free motion foot, a quarter inch piecing foot. Everything you see right there came with it. So right off the bat, it comes with 2 really cool extras that I didn't know were included. So let's pull this out. I'm gonna pause this and come right back. All right, so I just wanted to remove some of those styrofoam pieces real quick so you didn't have to hear that on the camera. So the machine has a handle. And so we go to lift it out at the store and I see something that made me so excited. Let me see if y'all can pick up on it. So, do y'all see what I see? The whole front of this machine is done in pink, and I have never been so excited in my life to pull something out of the box. In the store, this piece right here, this plate on the front, was tan. And so when this pulled out and it was pink, I was so excited. I'd already picked this machine. I knew it was a good machine, but to see it pink, I just knew that was exactly the machine that I was supposed to get. So in the box, it came with the machine, and it also has a cover for the machine. So let me pull that out of the bag. All right, so it has the cover, a hard cover, which is nice because a lot of your machines nowadays don't come with a hard cover. And so the hard cover just slips right over top of the machine, and it's catching on something. There it goes, right there, okay? So let me tip this down, let you see it. So see, it just puts right over top, which is nice because that's gonna keep it from getting dusty, and the handle can raise up while the cover is on, which is good. So you can carry it with its case on it. So then right here in the middle, it has the presser foot, but this machine can be operated with or without the presser foot. I've never used a machine without a presser foot, and so I'm sure I'll stick with this for a while. But presser foot is in here. And then, let's see. In the bottom of the box, here is the power cord. So obviously we really need this. It also, what I'm super excited about, has this table that extends off of the front of the machine right here, because that way when I'm piecing together my quilts and they start to get pretty big and I need a good flat surface to work on, the table right here just snaps right onto the machine, and that is absolutely wonderful. I've never used one like this, but I've heard they are game changers. So I'm excited to get to sewing on this and use this with my next quilt. Also in the box, there is a manual. So there is a manual in English and in Spanish. We have both of them right here. And at the bottom of the bag, or in the bottom of the box, is another little bag of accessories. So in here it has some needles, it has bobbins, it has feet, all these cool things. So there it is right there. So I'm gonna plug in the machine and I'm gonna show you a few of the features that it has that I really liked. All right guys, I'm gonna try to hold the camera as steady as possible. But you can see the front of the machine right here. And then I have the bobbins one more time. Right there, those cute pink bobbins. So let me cut the machine on for you and show you what it does when it cuts on. So it has the switch over here on the side. All right. So first of all, one of the things I really liked about this machine is how bright it was down here. It has a really nice light. It has a top load bobbin, which is phenomenal because that way I can always see when my bobbin thread is about to run out. So I'll get in close right there for you. So top load bobbin, and this piece, we just pop it. Oops. There we go. And so it has blue thread in there because that's what we were just using in the store to test it out with. But there is that. And something cool I liked as well that I was actually looking for in a machine was this button right here. And that is the automatic thread cutter. So when I get through sewing a line, piecing something together, I can press that button and it will cut the thread for me. But if I don't want to do that, it has the thread cutter right here that you just pull the thread against. So all of those things are good. If you know anything about quilting, it has a decent amount of throat space right here. And this is where we call the throat of the machine. This having good throat space is wonderful if you're piecing a quilt, because you may have to roll up the quilt and put it over here to try to run a piece through. It's not massive by any means. The size is actually pretty on par with my last machine, but it's a good amount. There are some machines that have a lot less throat space than this. Here are all of these stitches that come on the machine. So a really cool feature about this machine, you can see each stitch is numbered 00 all the way through 59. So we have 60 stitches on this machine. And it's everything from regular straight stitches to some decorative ones, so on and so forth, buttonholes, all of that. Now, if you look right here, right now, these two numbers are telling me which stitch I have selected. So right now it says 00, and 00 is just my regular straight stitch. So if I wanted to change out the stitch, sometimes it's hard to know which foot you want to use, because if you're trying to maybe make a zigzag stitch, but you don't have the correct foot on, you could break your needle. So right here, if you see, it has a presser foot, whoops, a presser foot, and it has the letter A. And that is currently the foot that I already have on the machine, is foot A. But if I change my stitch, so I'm going to go up. Let's see. There you go. So I took it to stitch 14, just like that, using these buttons over here to go to move it wherever this line is at, is the number I'm going to change. So see, I'm 24, 14, presser foot G. It goes ahead and tells me which presser foot I need to put on the machine. So 14 is this one right here. All right, so it tells me here I need presser foot G. And so what I can do is come down here, and the lever right here lifts up my presser foot. And on the back, there's another lever. I press it, and it drops my foot, okay? So on all of the feet that come from Janome, you see that letter A right there? That tells me what foot it is. So if I know I need foot A, if my machine's telling me I need foot A, they're already labeled for me. So there is that. Absolutely wonderful. I loved that. Now, I told you that this could be operated without a presser foot, and this is the speed. This controls the speed of how fast it would go and start and stop right here. This is needle up and needle down, and this is to finish off my stitch. So yeah, I am very, very excited to get to use my machine. And real quick, let me show you the table. All right, so here's the table that I was telling you about. And it has measurements on the bottom. I don't know how accurate they are, but it has them if you're someone who wants to use that. Right here, this folds down, so I can store all of my extra bits and pieces in here. But it also pulls off so I can put my table on. So let's look. On the back of my table, it has legs that fold down. And so I can fold these legs out. Here's my presser foot. We don't want to lose that. So fold all of these legs out. And if you look at the feet on the legs, they're actually screws. That way I can make sure I always have a level surface. But for the sake of today, we won't worry about making it super level. So this goes right on here. And you can see it's a little high, because really we want this to be flush with the machine. So I could go and screw down the feet on this table. And now I have an awesome working area for when I'm piecing together my quilts. So I went ahead and opened up this little baggie that it came with, all these nice goodies. Let me show you what was in there. It comes with this little felt piece that would go on the end of your spool when you're using that. It also comes, this machine is able to use two needles, so it comes with a spot to hold an extra spool. So this just pops in right here, and I can put an extra spool of thread right there. It comes with all of these feet. There is C, E, F, G, a brush to clean everything out with, and this, which we know is every sewer's best friend and arch nemesis. Let me pull it out. The seam ripper. So, there you go. Nice little seam ripper. So it comes with all of these things. There's needles in here. This is a little screwdriver. Everything you need to get going with your machine. But also, on top of all of this stuff that it comes with, you can't forget the extra bobbins. Extra bobbins. This
is the quilting attachments. And so in here, I know I mentioned it previously, but it has the walking foot, the free motion foot, and things I don't even know what they are, but they are in here, okay? So I am extremely excited to get this going.
All right, guys, so that is a quick overview of my new sewing machine. And if you want to see a more in-depth look at everything, I would gladly show that to you. But I just wanted to give you an overview of what came in the box, what came with the machine, and some of the functions that it had. So I hope you have a blessed day, and I will see you later.